In this video, we are going to create an indicator for a cell trailing stop like this one. This one is triggered by the SAR indicator. So let's find out how to do that with MQL4. To get started, please click on the little icon here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file Simple SAR Cell Trailing Stop, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the onTick function. And let's also remove the two command lines here. We start with a global variable for the SAR value, but we don't assign any value right now because this needs to be calculated. Inside of the onTick function, we want to find out if the function orders_total delivers a return value of 0. In that case, we have no open orders. And we also want to know if the current SAR value is above the current ask price. And if that is the case, we use the orderSend statement to open a sell trade for 10 microlot. Please remember, we only do that on a demo account. You wouldn't open a test position on a real account, but we need something to adjust the trailing stop. Afterwards, we use the ISAR function that comes with MQL4 for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart. And these parameters here is what you see if you click on Insert, Indicators, Trend, Parabolic SAR. Here we have a step value of 0.02 and a max value of 0.2. So let's click on OK. Right click into the chart, select Template, Save Template, and save it as tester.tpl. You can override the old value because tester.tpl is the template that is going to be used in the strategy tester. But back to the source code. If the current SAR value is above the ask price, we want to check the SAR buy stop. But this function doesn't exist so far, so we need to code it now. Our user-defined function checkSAR buy stop has no return value, so we use void here. Now we go through all the open orders by using a for loop. We use orderSelect for the current counter value, and with select by position and mode underscore trades, all in capital letters, we select an order. Afterwards, we check if the current order symbol equals the symbol on the chart. And we also want to know if the current order type equals OP underscore sell. That would be the case when we have a sell trade. And of course, it only makes sense to adjust the trailing stop if the conditions are right. We want to adjust the order sell stop if the current order stop loss is bigger than the current SAR value, or if the order stop loss equals 0. That would be the case the first time we run the expert advisor. To adjust the stop loss, we use order modify for the current ticket. With the order open price, we modify the stop loss to fit the SAR value. The order take profit value will not be changed. And that's also the case for the expiration date. We don't need that. And we don't need a color. So basically, the only change is the value for the stop loss here. Finally, we need to close the loops and the function. And that's about it. Well, if you don't understand what all the code here does, or if this was too fast for you, maybe you want to watch one of the other videos in this basic video series, or maybe even the premium course on our website might be interesting for you. For now, please click on the compile button. You shouldn't see any errors here, and if that is the case, you can click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, we have already saved this template here as tester.tpl. If you haven't done it so far, please do it now. And afterwards, we want to click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Please pick the new file simple SAR celltrailingstop.ex4. Mark the option for the visual mode here and start a test. Here is our expert advisor. We already see the first trailing stop for a sell trade. So the expert advisor is working as expected. And in this little video, you have learned how to code a trailing stop for the SAR indicator. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL4 code.